Let's analyze Doppler's effect when source and observer are not moving along the same line. A similar situation we can see here. There are two cars which are moving on roads intersecting at right angle. Say car 1 is moving at a speed V1, car 2 is moving at a speed V2. Say in this situation, car 1 produces a horn of frequency N0. You know, well, due to an isotropic source, the sound is produced in all directions. And say at the instant when car has produced a horn, say car 2 was located far away from this crossing. And when the sound of this horn approaches this position of car 2, car 2 has reached here. That means we can say this is the position of car 1 we have drawn in picture where it has produced the horn. And the picture of car 2 which we can see in the picture is the position when it will receive the sound of this horn of car 1. And obviously when car 2 is hearing, the driver of car 2 is hearing the sound, car 1 will not be located at this position, it will be somewhere at a forward location. Now say we wish to find out the apparent frequency heard by the driver of car 2, we can easily calculate apparent frequency of horn as heard by driver of car 2. This N apparent can be written as its frequency is N0, and along the line of sight car 1 is moving with the speed V1 and this angle is theta, so we can assume that the source or car 1 is approaching car 2 with the speed V1 cos theta 1, and as car 2 is moving at the instant when the driver is hearing the sound with the speed V2 and this angle we are given as theta 2. So the observer is approaching along the line of sight with the speed V2 cos theta 2. So in this situation, apparent frequency can be written as the actual frequency multiplied by, if we consider sound speed to be C from source to observer, as both are approaching, we can use C plus V2 cos theta 2 upon C minus V1 cos theta 1. Here V2 cos theta 2 we are taking as the speed of observer and V1 cos theta 1 as the speed of source. So this is the apparent frequency recorded by the driver of car 2. And in such a way, we can analyze all situations when source and observer are not moving in same line. We just need to take the velocity components of a source as well as observer along the line of sight, and we can apply the relation of Doppler's effect to handle such situations.